Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld. I got my coffee. Grab yours, because today we're going to take a look around the world at pictures based off of places. All right, everyone. So places is really a nice feature within photos because it plots all of your photographs across the map by GPS location. And instead of searching for pictures by people or by time, you can just say, oh, I know it was in Chicago where I took that picture. I just don't know what time or when it was. So if you know that location, it's really nice to be able to find that picture. When you open up Photos, on the left-hand side, you will have a category under the library called Places. Now, if I click on Places, this shows me essentially a map. And to start off, there's three ways to view the map across the top. We have Map, we have Satellite, and then we have Grid. Now, map is just a generic, think of like a map that you would buy at a gas station. So it just has the roads, it doesn't show the trees, all of that kind of stuff. That's where satellite will show you that. So it's just visually different. And if I click on grid, it's just showing you in chronological order the photos in more of a thumbnail fashion. And you can click on the name and it takes you directly to that place and then shows you all of the photographs from that location. I can click on the back arrow in the top left here and that brings me back, and then I can go back to map and or satellite. Now, one thing to note, if you're taking pictures with a smartphone, like an iPhone or an Android, they're all GPS enabled devices, meaning that every single time you take a photo or video, it's stamping that metadata to that image and it associates it with the map. If you have a DSLR camera or a point and shoot, a lot of those cameras will have that, but some of them will not have a GPS chip in, so you would have to add the date or the location later. Now, one thing that I regret doing is not enabling GPS on my camera earlier, because there's a lot of photos that I took across the United States or across the country, and I really wish that I had enabled it prior, but I was thinking in my mind, I wanted to conserve battery life because it may, you know, always be looking for GPS and then it will drain my battery life. I don't know if that's true or not. I'm guessing it might be a little bit, but I realized that I already have 4 or 5 extra batteries, which again, if you don't have extra batteries for your camera, get them. But I really wish I had turned GPS on because there's so many photos now that I don't have associated on a map. So that's just a side note, turn your GPS on. I like to look at it in satellite view personally. And if I click and hold on the map, notice I can just drag it around. If I double click on the map, it's gonna zoom me into that location. There's other controls in the bottom right here. Notice you have the little minus sign to zoom in and out, as well as you can turn the map, and there's a little 3D button. But notice how the 3D button is not enabled. It's not there. So we have to zoom in far enough where it actually has 3D enabled, and I'll show you that in a second. But let's go ahead and if we look at this, notice it's just literally plotting all my photos on the map of where they were taken because it's all by GPS. So if I zoom in farther, they're just going to spread out even farther because all of these pictures were someplace. So I know that if I click on here, it's gonna automatically take me to where I took these family photos of this family. If I go back to the arrow on the top, I can go to, you know, here's these pictures of Hudson and my kids. So we were someplace in Albertville, probably the mall. And so it's really nice to be able to just look on a map and find your pictures based off of place. Really helpful. Now, what's really fun is let's go ahead, I'm gonna zoom out. And you can also, if you have a trackpad, if you use two fingers, you can pinch to zoom in and out, which is also nice. And you can use two fingers also around to scroll up and down and move the map around. Now, I wanna show you this 3D option because I think it's really cool. And we're gonna head to Chicago for that. So if I scroll in closer to Chicago, notice I can now click on 3D. So what that does is it actually turns the map into a 3D map. where I can zoom in even farther, and now I actually have the pictures mapped out in a 3D environment within a large city. So it's really kind of cool. Some things that are helpful is, you know, I can move the map around like this, and the way that you do that is if you hold down Option on the keyboard, hold down Option and then click and hold, and you're able to kind of rotate and tilt the map up a little bit easier. But what's really cool is, you know, I can see, and if I can zoom down even farther, a lot of these pictures here where we took a boat ride, a water taxi, and we were on the water. So it's showing us these photographs while we are on the water going through. And literally it's just planting all of the photographs on a map in this 3D environment. So it's really cool to even go back and look at all of these pictures in a different way. You know, here's St. Paddy's Day, Chicago. You've never been to Chicago for St. Paddy's Day? Here's what it looks like. It's insane. It's a lot of people. And it's green, very green. I'm not Irish. Actually, side note, I took one of those, not Ancestry, whatever the DNA stuff, not 23, yeah, no, I took Ancestry. All of my life, I thought I was Italian. I'm not Italian. Although, I'm not sure how accurate it is spitting into a cup and sending that to some imaginary scientist, but I thought that was kind of really interesting and disappointing, because maybe I wanted to be Italian, but I was told my whole life I was Italian, but I'm not Italian. So, yeah. End of rant. Back to the photos. If I zoom back out then, it's just a really nice way to see all of my pictures. And they're gonna be everywhere. So if I zoom back out, I can even look around the world, scroll in here, and this is gonna show me, took a trip to Israel, which was just phenomenal. And here it shows me all of the photos where we are at. So it's gonna show you everywhere. If you love to travel or just around the United States, anywhere you go, being able to find pictures based off of location is really, really fun. Here's a good example. So these are the streets of Tel Aviv. And here's what the trees look like. Isn't that cool? I want trees like that here in Minnesota. I don't think it'll happen, but really cool. So, that's places in a nutshell. Now, let's say that we have a photograph that we don't have GPS enabled. So I have some pictures, I think out from California that I took that don't have a picture or a location associated with it. And some of the ways that I can tell is if you notice in the top right-hand side of the picture, notice how it has like a little pin with the line. That represents that there's a location already associated with that photo. So if I click on info here, it's already gonna say, yep, this picture was in Los Angeles. Now, if I go back and I look at, let's say this picture here, notice there's no pin. If I click the little eye, it's not there. Now, this is where you can, though, assign a location if you didn't have GPS enabled. If I go back to the little eye and pull up the information on the photograph, I can actually start to assign a location right here. And this was Santa Monica Pier. So it's gonna pull the address and everything, and I can just click on that, and now that picture is associated with that location. So really helpful. Even if you can't assign, or even if you don't have GPS, you can still assign photos doing this method. It just takes a lot longer. So if you have GPS, highly worth it. Enable it on your camera. Don't worry about your phones. It's already got it there. And yeah, that's places. Places is really, really kind of cool to be able to, again, find your photos based off of location and not time or date. So thanks for watching. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and support and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.